Good morning, everybody. The next unit is the outbreak of the revolution. Under this, we'll know about what were the causes of the revolution, French Revolution. Louis XVI had to increase taxes for reasons you have learnt in the previous section. That means you know, in the previous section, we had discussed about the several reasons why France was running shortage of money, and the king had to increase the taxes to cover up that shortage of money. So he had to increase the taxes for several reasons, but in practically monarch had no power to increase the taxes on his own wish, and he had to call the meeting. That meeting is known as Estates General. What is this Estates General then? To pass the proposal, he had to call the meeting of Estates Generals. This is a political body. A State General is a political body to which the three states sent their representatives. It is a quite a different type of government, you know, there. So, a State General is a political body to which the three states. Who are the three states? One is nobility, first one is clergy, second is nobility, and third one is peasants. And these states sent their representative. These three states, they will send their representatives who will comprised of Estates Generals. The monarch alone had the powers to decide about the meetings. The last time it was done in 1614. Now let us discuss the Estates Generals Assembly. Louis XVI had called together an assembly of the Estates General on 5th May 1789 to pass the proposal for new taxes. The first and second estates sent 300 representatives, and it was held in Versailles. That means from first estate it was 300 representatives, and next is also 300, who were seated in rows facing each other on two sides, while the 600 members of the third estate had to stand at the back because they belong to the last one, last category. The third estate had the most powerful people, and this was represented by its more prosperous and educated members. More educated members belong to the last, that is called third estate. Peasants, artisans, and women. Who were those people? Peasants, artisans, women were denied entry to the assembly. Means they were not allowed to make an entry to the assembly. They had to remain at the outside. Demands and grievances of these artisans, peasants, and women were listed in some 40,000 letters which the representatives had brought with them. That means their problems, grievances that had to be written in the letters, those letters to be sent through some members to the assemblies. They themselves were not allowed to enter the assembly. See, what were the demands of the third estate? Demand for voting the democratic way. It is the demand made by the third estate. This time the Estates General demanded a democratic method of voting. Louis XVI also was determined to continue the same practice, but this time members of the third estate demanded that voting now be conducted by the assembly as a whole. That means all will take the part, was the demand of third estate, where each member would have one vote. This idea was given by philosophers like Rousseau in his book that is called The Social Contract. When this proposal is rejected by the king, members of the third estate walked out of the assembly in protest. That means the third estate, the demand was not satisfied by the king, therefore they left that assembly hall and walked away, and they said that they will to protest. The representatives of the third estate viewed themselves as spokesperson for the whole French nation. On 20th June, they assembled in the hall of an indoor tennis court in the grounds of Versailles. That is called the National Assembly of Third Estate. They declared themselves a National Assembly and swore not to disperse till they had drafted a constitution for France, and that would limit the power of the monarch. That means they all remained in the Versailles in the tennis court, and there they drafted the constitution and said that that constitution would limit or reduce the power of monarch. They were led by Mirabai and Abysseus. They were the leaders of this third estate. Mirabai was born in a noble family but was convinced of the need to do away with a society of feudal privileges. He brought out a journal and delivered powerful speeches to the crowds assembled at Versailles. And the second one is Abysseus, who wrote an influential pamphlet that is called What is the Third Estate? What happened next is the question. The answer is revolt in Bastille. While the National Assembly was busy at Versailles drafting the constitution, the rest of France faced a bad harvest, and that led to increase of prices of bread, and this made bakers to exploit the situation and hoard the supplies. After spending hours in long queues at the bakery, the crowds of angry women attacked the shops. At the same time, the king also ordered his troops to move into Paris. Let us discuss the effects of this Bastille revolt. On 14th July, the agitated crowd stormed and destroyed the Bastille. Second is, in the countryside, the rumor spread that the lords of manor who had hired the brigands who were on their way to destroy the ripe crops. The second one. Third one is, with this fear, the peasants in several districts, they seized the hoes and pitchforks and attacked chetoks. Next, the peasants looted hoarded grain, burnt down documents containing records of manorial dues. And the last one is, a large number of nobles fled to neighboring countries. Next is end of special privileges. Faced with the power of his revolting subjects, finally, Louis XVI recognized the National Assembly and accepted that his powers would from now on be checked by the Constitution. So, faced with the fear of his revolting subjects mean the people, Louis XVI finally accorded recognition to the National Assembly and accepted the principle. He had to accept the principle that his power would from now be checked by the constitution. That means he would be checked by a perfect constitution. On the night of 4th August 1789, remember these dates, France passed the law for abolishing the feudal system of obligations and taxes, and the number of clergy were also forced to give up their privileges. Titres were abolished and lands owned by the church were confiscated at the end. As a result, the government acquired assets with at least 2 billion livres. In this way, there was an end of special privileges because of availability of the constitution there, because the king had to follow the principles of constitution now. The next subtopic is France becomes a constitutional monarchy. How France become the constitutional monarchy? The National Assembly completed the draft of the constitution in 1791. Its main object was, what was the main objective of this constitution, was to limit the power of the monarch. The new constitution gave a final blow to absolute monarchy. Instead of the powers being concentrated in one hand, the powers were now separated and assigned to different institutions like legislature, executive and judiciary in our country. This change of power made France a constitutional monarchy. What is constitutional monarchy? Means the monarchy had to follow the constitutional principles. The laws made by the National Assembly. Under the new constitution, the laws were to be made by the National Assembly. That is, citizens voted for a group of electors who in turn chose the assembly. That means some of the changes were made here and these changes were known as the laws. What changes were made here? The Constitution of 1791 vested the power to make laws in the National Assembly, which was indirectly elected. So let us discuss what were the laws, what are the things, changes were brought here. First one, the men who were above 25 years of age, in the voting only the changes were made. Who can give the vote here? Here that is the those who are called the active citizen, they can give the vote. The passive are not allowed to give the vote. Who are active and who are passive? Let us discuss. The men who were above 25 years of age and who paid the taxes equal to at least 3 days of laborers' wages were given the status of active citizens. It means that they had the right to vote, and the remaining men and all women were known as passive citizens. This is number one. In right giving the right to vote. Second was to qualify as a voter and then as a member of the assembly, a man had to belong to the highest bracket of taxpayers. That means the person who wanted to give the vote, he had to remain in the bracket of the highest taxpayer. That means he should pay the highest amount of tax. And the next is, the Constitution began with a declaration of the rights of man and citizen. Then some of the rights were given to man and the citizens. According to this declaration, right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, and equality before law were established as natural rights, and it was the duty of the state to protect these. These rights were given to the people, and these rights to be protected by the state. That means here the constitutional monarchy. So these are the laws were made by the National Assembly after the Constitution was formed.